Thank you. Israël.
David the king of Israel.
What
wealth? The wealth there.
David.
David.
Roi d'Israël.
The king of Israel.
I have nothing more that could
possibly
be good.
But let's read the Bible. Let's read.
Isaiah chapter 55, verse 10 to 11.
Isaiah chapter 55, verse 10 to 11.
Si ma totalité, Samuel chapitre 2, verse 4.
And then we will read 2 Samuel.
Je souviens que c'est dans 2 Samuel chapitre 5, verset 11.
And then we will end in 2 Samuel chapter 2, verse
11. Mais la ligne au veillé dans le verset du mal.
I want you to pay attention to two verses.
Le béni va quand même un peu différent.
It speaks in things a bit different.
Oui.
Nous lisons le livre de Isaïe 55, versets 10 à 11. Je lis au nom de Jésus-Christ. 10. Comme la pluie et la neige descendent des cieux, il n'y retourne pas sans avoir arrosé, féconder la terre et fait germer les plantes sans avoir donné de la semence au semeur et du pain à celui qui mange. Ainsi en est-il de ma parole qui sort de ma bouche. Elle ne retourne point à moi sans effet, sans avoir exécuté ma volonté et accompli mes desseins.
Alléluia.
10. Po ete lokola mbula, pe mbula, pe mbe, ikolowa na lola, pe ikonjonga kuna te, kasi ikoponisa mabele. Ete ebimisa biloko na yango, mpe itoisa yango. Kopesa kamboto epai na mokoni, pe kwanga epai na mokoni.
For as the rain comes down and the snow from heaven and do not return there, but water the earth and make it bright forth on birth, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater.
Oh,
ekokutwa epai na ngai pamba te, kasi ekosukisa oyo ekani ngai, ekolonga na likambo libindaki ngai yango.
Ekolonga na likambo ngai Nzambe natindaki yo.
So shall my words be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the things for which I sent it.
Yes. Samuel.
2 Samuel 2, verset 4. Les hommes de Juda vinrent, et là ils joignirent David.
Les hommes de
Juda. Les hommes de Juda vinrent, et là ils joignirent David pour roi sur la maison de Juda. On informa David que c'était les gens de Jabès en Galade qui avaient enterré Saul.
Batona Yuda bayaki pewana. Bapakona ki Dawidi lokola mokonzi na libota na Yuda. Balobaki na Dawidi ete. Bato na Yabese bilata bakundaki Saul.
Amen. Then the men of Judah came, and there they anointed David king over the house of Judah. And they told David, saying, the men of Jabes Gilead were the ones who buried Saul.
2 Samuel 5, du 1er au 3e verset. Toutes les tribus d'Israël vinrent auprès de David à Hébron et dirent, voici nous sommes tes os et ta chair.
Israël est mon babayaki et pas de Dawidi, na ebelo ni balobaki na yekete. Tala biso tozali batona moko a moko na yo pe na mosuli moko na yo.
Then all the tribes of Israel came to David at Hebron and spoke, saying, indeed we are your bone and your flesh.
Deux. Autrefois déjà, lorsque Saul était notre roi, c'était toi qui conduisais et qui ramenais Israël. L'Éternel t'a dit, tu pèteras mon peuple d'Israël et tu seras le chef d'Israël.
Nantango eleki, wana saulu ajalaki mokonji likolo na biso. Obimisaki mpe obutwisaki Israele. Pe Yawe alobaki na yo ete, yo okozala mobateli na bato na ngai Israele, yo mpe okozala mokolo likolo na Israele.
Also in time past, when Saul was king over us, you were the one who led Israel out and brought them in. And the Lord said to you, you shall shepherd my people Israel and be ruler over Israel. Let's pray. Father of glory, King of kings and Lord of lords, Father, I praise you. Father, I glorify you. Let your spirit guide us, strengthen
us,
speak to us of the depth of your heart's
desire,
and take authority upon anything that does not confess your name where we are. I capture its power and I throw it into dry places. In the name of Jesus Christ, God of Nazareth,
the
living God.
Amen.
So we have someone here that has a testimony.
Have a seat.
We have someone here that has a
testimony.
We do have a fellow brother who wishes to thank God. Oh, God has done great. Be very brief. What has the Lord done?
Hallelujah.
My name is Father Tadeikwa.
There
was a certain issue. I have two testimonies. The first one is last week, Tuesday, on the 25th of December. It was my birthday. But I was a bit touched by the way a mother had testified the Thursday before. The way a Congolese person had died that same
25th.
When we were on study, they were telling us that 52,000 people die on a daily basis. I came on the internet and I saw that the amount had increased. Meaning that tomorrow the same amount of people will die as well.
Alors témoignage ami balais ça surtout pour la présence en dans la quartier.
My second testimony is mainly about my presence within the church. I went to the gym somewhere. And I had gone overboard and then had an accident. It was around summertime. And I would have to drink juice all the time because it was too hot. And as soon as I drank juice, I fell into a coma. My wife had called an ambulance. And they sent two women. They said he's too big.
But
you take him and put him within the
ambulance.
My wife and my child who
was
done everything they could to put me into
the ambulance.
Within the seventh, they said that there's no space. They took me to Wood Cross Hospital. When I fell, I saw as if it was the world was turning. When I had woken up, I saw that there were still a lot of short people.
I said, okay, I must be with this
world.
But in the hall, at the back, it was very dark
glasses.
And the testimonies, they say that when you go to hell, the demons I said, because the demons have not carried me, means I said, God, why have you done this? How can he lead me to die and have a child? Why have you done this to me? And those people were speaking in a language that I did not understand. And I told them that I want to see God because I couldn't actually hear
them. Jesus is not here.
And one of them had said to me, Jesus is not here.
He
said, Jesus is not here, it's just us.
You
know, who are you guys? They said, we are nurses who are with the
Whipcross.
When I saw this, I was like, okay, but I'm not there.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let the Lord be glorified.
We
remove the crutches from the hands of our Father. Today, all the illnesses that he had has now been
healed.
Stay quiet.
David,
the king of Israel. Before I get into the depth of the things that the Lord wants to speak to us about, when we first started the foundation of the teaching of the life of David, we did put as like an altar upon one specific verse. Every time before I start the
prediction,
I will start there. Who has the idea? The path of the Lord is not our path. The thoughts of the Lord is not our thoughts. Thus says the Lord.
Oui, Oyowana is a lucky foundation.
That was the foundation in which we needed to sow for the people of God in the world. Every time when a person builds a home, when they're done, they put a door. Once they put the door, they will put a key so that no one can enter. Is that true? Is that true? Before I give the key that we are about to lock the door with, the verse that our mother has said, where is it written? The path of the Lord is not our path. The thoughts of the Lord is not our way. Thus says the Lord. Where is it written? Isaiah 55, verse 8. But today, I want you to get that key that you are about to look. The foundation of the home, all the teachings in which we have received within the past month. The key says, the words of the Lord is like the rain. When it comes from the heaven,
Et
leaves the heaven. The words of God. When God speaks within this world upon your life, those words, it can never return to the heavens unless it fulfills what the Lord has said. Just take that. Remember that. No matter the witches, no matter the sinners, no matter the enemies that may stand in front of you, write it within your brain. Write it within your thought that the words of God is that rain within my life. It can never return unless it fulfills itself within my life. Do you understand? Do you understand? Let me run quickly.
David.
When he returned from when they burnt their city and took their wives, the Bible states, when he returned,
David,
had heard that Saul had passed away. Is that right? When David had died, when Saul died, children of God, I told you to pay attention to those two verses.
2
Samuel chapter 2 verse 4 and 2 Samuel chapter 5 verse 1 to 3. Those are two things. The first thing, the people of Judah had come and crowned David as the king within their city. But Judah was not the whole of Israel. It's just a whole tribunal. Within Israel.
How?
How is it that David was only crowned as the king within Judah, rather than be the king of the whole of Israel? But in verse 5, 1 to 3, that's when it then spoke of David becoming the king of the whole of Israel. Now we need to know. What had actually happened to cause David to go into two different paths? One as a king of Judah and then as a king of the whole of Israel. The words of God within your life is like a rain. If it has not yet fulfilled the work in which it has been sent to do, it does not return.
Amen.
Listen to it. And within it, that's how we
live.
David, when he heard that Saul had died, David had one specific principle in which I repeat every day to the children of God.
Come on.
How?
David.
David.
Jamais.
David could never do anything without consulting God first. Listen to a real believer. And a person that's walking with these principles, I tell you, every day you will succeed in your life. You know what?
You are doing what the Lord is telling you to do. God never fails. God does not stutter. God works with precision, and what he says is what will occur.
David,
he prayed to God. He said, God, Saul is now dead. Brothers and sisters, David had mourned over Saul. I'm asking myself, the heart that God had given David, what type of a person was he? He should have rejoiced that Saul was dead. Now I will replace.
No.
David. He mourned. He mourned over Saul. I want to explain it like this.
David,
within his mind, he had nothing to do with being crowned. David asked God. He said, God,
Saul
is now dead. Should I go to a city within Israel? So for him to even leave where he was, David was asking for the Lord's permission. The Lord said yes. Go. He asked God. Israel has many cities. Which city should I go to exactly? And the Lord had said to David, he said, David, go to Judah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
David went to Judah not as a king, but he went to Judah like everyone else, like a person within the family of Israel, because the person that has seek for his death is now. He said, okay, let me go back to the city. The Bible states,
David,
when he got to Judah, the elders within Judah, the people of Judah, the elders of Judah, they are the ones that came towards David. It's not that David is the one that went to look for
him.
You know very well. Me, God is the one that said, I have to become king. Now, because Saul is dead, you should vote for me. That one says you. No, David didn't work like that.
David!
He came, he got to Judah, and he sat like everyone else. And 600 people that he had, men and women. And the elders of the land, they all came to look. They said, David, we must now crown you. And you will become the king of Judah. You, from today, king of Judah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. David akomati.
And David became king.
Listen. Yoka phrases.
Listen, brothers and sisters. There are people who are suffering on earth. The pain that they are feeling. It's because they are forcing something which the Lord has not told them to go and do. One day, I was preaching here. I told you guys that elevation, the elevation of God, you don't follow it. The elevation of God, it comes towards the person that the Lord had stood up.
Let me explain. You can be born within a family of 100. There could be 12 of you in a family. But if God has said His word within the heavens and is coming down like rain, okay.
Okay.
Amen.
So
if God He speaks upon a family member, you both come out of the same parent. He's never studied. He doesn't know anything. If the words are coming from the heavens, it will never return until it touches that specific member. And within the family, you need to be able to accept that person's elevation. Because that person, God, has elevated them for all your welfare. David, he did not go to seek for the wealth. It was not his words that had pushed him. David wanted to know exactly what is the Lord going to do within my life. Let me tell a member here. You can never help God.
No.
Never. God, you can't help him.
David.
He sat there for 7 years and 6 months. That within the king of Judah. Within Judah. 7 years. And 6 months. He would be there with his small group of people and the rest was set aside. Question. What exactly caused David to not rule over the whole of Israel all at once? Listen to the answer. When Saul had passed, the Bible says that he passed with 3 of his children. But the reality is one of his children had not passed. One of his children had not died. And that child's name was Ismoset. When Saul had died, the leader of the arms of Saul's army, his name was Abner. When Saul had passed, he decided to put Saul's child like a leader within all the different sectors. And it's 4 different tribunals. 4 different tribunals.
Chef d'état-major général a dit,
the leader had then put him. He said, you as the king. Amen. And then
Ishbosheth has proclaimed roi.
Ishbosheth had proclaimed himself as a king.
David.
Zam.
God, give me the heart of this man. He didn't rush for anything. He didn't worry himself. He just sat within Judah. Them within their own
lives.
And him within Judah. One tribunal. All the other different tribunals were set aside. Whereas David was quite strong. He had his army. But why did he not go and fight? The blessings of God. You cannot go and rush for it. What the Lord has said that you will be is exactly who you will be. Amen. People may stand against you. People may reject you. What the heavens have said upon you will accomplish itself no matter what.
Amen.
Amen.
Et donc, on dit, et ça, là, David, aya koko maroua Israël.
What caused David to become the king of the whole of Israel?
Réponse est à vous.
Answer.
Yo.
Listen.
Encore un mot?
One day.
David azalaki na chef ya armée.
David was with the leader of his army.
Komo ya chef ya armée.
And the name of the
Yoab
was Yoab.
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 Et d'abord on va komi na Juda.
When they got to Judah,
chef ya armée ya David,
the leader of the of David's army,
azalaki obligé ba positionner ba soldats par-ci par-là pour la sécurité.
They were obliged to position soldiers everywhere for the security of the city.
Mais,
but,
ezalaki na lisi ba moko ezalaki pembeni quelque part.
But there was a specific well within a specific area.
Abinel.
And Abner, who was the leader of Saul's army, had taken everyone that went to the specific well. Once they got there, Yoab, who was the leader of David's army, he also took his soldiers and brought them towards the same well. When they got there, you know, if you're walking around with a servant of God who is a person of peace, you also need to have peace. That seed must then transfer to you. A people of David, they came to the well, and they saw everyone. They saw everyone, and they didn't even pay attention. They saw
Abner,
and they knew him as the leader of Saul's army. You and I, we don't have a problem.
Abner
had called Yoab. He said, "You, you're David. These are all David's people." He said, "You take 12 men from your side, I will take 12 from my side, and let's let them fight in front of us." Brothers and sisters, listen to the beginning of the
battle.
Those things were occurring, and David did not know the beginning or the end. Let me tell what that was. There are other things that God may leave time to a man. That you may play with the things of God. That you may play with the plans of God. The Lord has given you time because His own planning is within a long period of time. I want to say like this. If the plan of the Lord is short, it's for Him to accomplish what He has promised. The Lord does not leave man time. Are you listening to me? And if a person imposes themselves on top of the Lord, but in that period, the person will die. The person will lose their life.
So,
I want to explain it like this. Saul had a very long time. He had a lot of time to fight against David. To kill, try and kill David. He continued to live. The Lord could see. The Lord was protecting David. When Saul had died, the Lord did not leave anyone time. Listen to the things that had started. The battle had started. 12-12. The Bible says that David's men were much stronger. They killed Abner's
people,
those that were within Saul's side. The Bible says that there was a great battle.
19
men of David's had died. But Saul's soldiers, 360 of them died. That battle, David didn't even know the beginning or the ending. He had no idea what was happening.
Hallelujah. Alléluia.
Amen. Let me tell you,
frères et sœurs,
brothers and sisters, when
Abner
had seen that the battle was too much, he didn't start to run. He started to run. He stood on top of a mountain. He said, "Yo, why is it our own nation we are fighting?" Then they already killed
you.
He couldn't handle the battle. And when the leader of Abner had then heard, he said he blew with an horn. He blew a horn. And all the soldiers had stopped. He brought them all back together. He said, let's no longer fight because they cannot handle
it.
What had happened? That same night, Abner had then continued his journey to go ahead because Joab and his men had stayed and gone backwards towards their position. Whereas Abner, he went all the way to David in Judah. And he got there. He did not tell David what had occurred. He looked at him and said, no. David himself is not here and I couldn't handle his men. What if he himself was present? I would die. He came to David. David with a great heart. David was very
faithful.
David had a heart of God. And when he saw Abner, he hugged him. Listen to Abner. He said, David, I've come so that you and I can create an alliance. As you see here, capacity to tell the whole of Israel to come together and you can become their king.
Okay.
He said, okay. But go and bring your wife.
Amen.
Whereas Abner had married a
stone,
but you know that wife. That's the same wife that Saul had said to give to David to marry. Do you understand? Do you understand?
David, the one Israel.
David, the king of Israel. When Abner had come out to the king
David,
the leader of David's army had now come forward. As he was arriving, people had already told him. They said, we're very surprised. How? How can King David say, Abner, he greeted him with all joy and left him to leave? I want to say it like this. If you were born with a good heart, remain with that good heart. Are you listening? Are you listening? Having a good heart pays off. Having a good heart brings blessings within a man's life.
You
have told King David, you can't do that. When they finished talking,
chef of the army David Abimi,
the leader of David's army had come out. He sent soldiers to go call Abner. The Bible states, the Lord had caused an issue within Joab and Ishbosheth, who was the son of Saul. How? Saul had one girl on the side. He had a mistress. When Saul had passed, Abner, who was once the leader of the army, had now taken that mistress and made her his wife.
Nzambe.
God.
Asakana kadai.
He don't play with him.
Olo kibage.
Are you listening?
Nzambe se met trouble na na vi na yo na bato yo soza na mako ko comprendre.
The Lord can create an issue with all the people that you are around and you will never understand.
Isibose dami.
Ishbotek said.
Abinay.
Or Abner. How can you take the wife, the mistress of my father? This is where the separation now starts. He placed him as a king, right? Because he did not want David to become a whole king within Israel. Listen to me,
brother.
People may oppose against you. People can stand against you. They may even sit down and plot against you. But I want to tell you that they will never succeed. Why? The words of God within your life is that rain. At that rain, if it has not yet touched you, it will never return. Amen. Had separated. Abner was angry. He said, what? Everything that I have done for you. Everything that every good thing that I have done for you. Never accepted. Today you are now turning against me because of this mistress. He said, from today me and you will no longer.
Ishbosheth's
army had now separated.
Ishbosheth had reigned 2 years.
Ishbosheth had reigned for 2 years.
David had reigned 7 ans et 6 mois in Judah.
David had reigned 7 years and 6 months in Judah. And now calculate within your mind.
So it was 6 minus 2.
If we take 7 minus 2, it gives us 5. We add 6 months.
And so it was 7 ans et 6 mois.
Is that 5 years and 6 months all those people lived outside of the kingdom of David?
Amen.
The Bible says,
Yoab killed Bato, Babenga, Abinero as Rakishef Ya Arme ya Saul.
Yoab has sent people to call Abner, who was the leader of Saul's army. He called them. It was not David who said
that.
It was not David who said called
them.
Although he questioned David's status, why did you bring the leader of the army? David never replied. I was born with a good heart. And I will remain with a good heart. The Bible states, they saw Abner, they met Abner on his journey and they brought him back. And they put him to the side. Within a corner. Thinking that he's about to ask him something. And he killed him. He killed the leader of Saul's army. Now the situation was with David. When they told David, listen to the words of David. A great lesson
in
life. Within your life, do not rejoice in a person's blood. Do not rejoice in another man's sadness. David said, his blood is upon your head, Lord. Me, I am saved in front of the Lord. I want to explain it. Within your life, do everything possible to please God. Walk according to the will of God. Don't do wrong because people are sending you to David said. He didn't rush. Even if they killed him. No problem. The Bible states Ishbosheth was He feared once he heard of all of this. How did the son of Saul die?
Jonathan.
You know Jonathan. You know Jonathan. The Saul's child. The Bible said that he also had a child. One day they were running. That child fell. He now became crippled. They came out with a person that was actually looking after the child. When everything was ruined, the Bible
states,
they went into the house of Ishbosheth, who was the child of Saul. I'm telling you how God killed those people very quickly in order for him to accede to the plan he had planned for them. I want to give you an advice. He, if they had a chance to have at least 5 or 10 years remaining, when he fought against the children of God, be careful, because maybe you may not even last 5 years. Saul had 16 years, but Ishbosheth had 2 years, and his life had ended. The Bible states, they came as if people who were going to look for rice.
Jonathan's
son. Once they got into the
house,
they saw Saul's child, who was named Ishbosheth, who became king. He was sleeping. Under his sleep, they cut off his head. The people that killed him was not David's soldier. His own siblings. Look at how the Lord erased those people so that he could accomplish his plans quickly. I want to help you,
Mama.
Let me tell you. You see, some people, they can eat sin like that, as if they eat nuts, and they live perfectly fine. They can go to a
bar.
They can drink alcohol. If you want to copy that person, you will die before that person does. The Bible says, Ishbosheth had died. Did David go towards those 4 tribes?
No.
Did he send people to go and get along? They themselves then came towards David. Let me go back a bit. When David had stayed within Judah, when Abner and Ishbosheth now took the issue with the father's mistress, the truth had come out. Listen to the words of
Abner.
He said, "You Ishbosheth, I want to tell you. You know very well that the Lord has said that David must become king. What lesson do I want to tell you? People may know you, people may act as if they have not heard of what the Lord has said to you. People may close their ears to what the Lord has said that you will become tomorrow. But I want to tell you this. The truth is within their heart. It will never change. It will remain the truth. Even if they don't want to tell you, at the end of all that truth, they will vomit it out in front of people. Because the Lord said, nothing can be hidden.
Amen.
Amen.
David,
he sat down. He was only king of Judah.
did not rush towards anything. He did not fight for
anything.
He said, what the Lord has said that I shall be, that's exactly who I will be.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The Bible states,
Israel,
the elders of Israel had now gathered to say, they said, David, God
said
that you will guide us. Today, we have come to crown you. We have come to anoint you. From today, you will become the king of the whole of and the anointing
there.
David gathered everyone together. What lesson do I want to tell you? What lesson would I like to tell you? Listen to me. People will oppose against you. People will plot against you. People will try to reject what the Lord has said that you will be. People will try to ignore the seed of God that is within you. People will fight against you. I've come to tell you, don't fight against anyone. You don't fight against them. Why?
Abner
can stand against you.
Abner
can stand against you. question. My life, I just don't understand. My life, I don't know what's going on. The king has told me to tell you. Do you not worry? The words of God will make your life is like the rain. The words of God will make your life is like the rain. God within your life.
Lord,
he has said that you will be as who you will be. Although the days may go by, although the years have gone by, once the time that the Lord said that those things will be fulfilled is close, all those that were standing in front of you, their heavens will remove. You will see as if God is not well. Let me tell you, within that pain, within the things that you are going through, within the sufferings that you are going through, one day when we spoke about the David's trial, we said this. These soldiers, they wanted to kill their own blessing. When David became king, who was closest to David? Only those that wanted to kill David. They were the ones that became
ministers.
They became the advisors. They became the governors of the
nation.
I want to help you like this. In your life, when you will walk with someone that is a servant of God, you must be strong. You need to be strong. You need to be strong. The lack of knowledge is a whole death in a person. Believe. Ask God. Ask God. The person that I am with. The person that I'm walking with. Who are they to you, God?
even want to see them as
little kids. You. To kill me. Don't kill me. It's no problem. They then came. We were the ones that were with David.
But
wants to open the story. And
he
says, oh, you wanted to kill him. Amen.
David.
David. The king of Israel. Did he find?
Is
there something that he rushed for? The goodness of God. They called him. They said, David, God has said to us that you are the king. Even those that tried to create their own kingdom, David should have said, Saul died. And there would have been a space there for him to become the king. But where is this Ish-bosheth coming from? He's come to put another step
in.
David did not rush. A person that has God. They do not rush. They do not fight. They do not run. A person that has God. The king of Israel. That's it. The story. David.
David.
The king of Israel. Look at how the Lord had killed all the enemies of
Insectus.
Brothers and sisters. Be careful. Be careful with people that have received the word of God. If the time of God has come. If the Lord said at midnight on the first, this person has to be here. The Lord will not change it to Tuesday. But in contrast, God, He will erase you. He will erase you. So that His words can be accomplished within them.
Amen.
put them upon him. He said, right?
Let
me take
it
back.
So
the smell of those animals.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to tell
Father
them.
Don't see yourself as a woman. Don't see yourself as a child. Look at how the believers
should.
You see another one just says, you.
No,
no, no, no.
No. A person that has the Holy Spirit.
A person that has the Holy Spirit. They haven't spoken upon me. Must I even fight? I don't even need to know. I have one issue.
I'll find that silent before that two nines up.
Before doing anything, I should tell the Lord. One thing.
That's it.
That's exactly what David said. They want to fight him. They said, God. If I follow those people, they will say, God. They said, he succeeded. Before leaving the Philistines, he said, God. Soul is dead. What should I do? Should I go? The Lord said, go. He told me to go, but where exactly? There are people. They've had a dream. They don't yet know the beginning or the ending of that. And they start to run. They start to run. They're running, but that's not what the Lord has said. If they have not cooled, the Lord will speak. And if the Lord speaks, even if people say no, even if people speak, what he has said is exactly what
will happen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Family of God.
David
the king. I've come to tell
you.
This is a lucky
moment.